And when you look at it here, it's important. See, we've got to preach with boldness. And you say, well, wait a minute, I ain't called to be no preacher. It don't matter about your calling. Because you're a preacher whether you realize it or not. And tonight you say, well, wait a minute, is women saying that I'm a preacher? Hey, absolutely you are. You want to know why? Because, hey, the way that you live your life, hey, is what you're preaching in your life. When you, hey, it goes to bear. Because, hey, when you reach the end of your life and, hey, when they laid my body right here and, hey, the casket's right there and, hey, they open it up and, hey, what do you think is me? It ain't me. Hey, I'm not here, Randy. Hey, I done went on and graduated. Amen. But when they open it up and you look in there, there was nothing else will I be able to say. I done preached it. I done said what I had to say. Every word that was ever going to come out of my mouth has already came out right there at that point. There will be nothing else said here on this earth. You'll never hear anything else uttered from my lips unless God does something divinely. Hey, to make that happen, nothing else will be said. But you know, my life will have already been preached itself. My funeral, hey, the one that stands behind this and says a few words, hey, that won't be the one that's really preaching my sermon. Hey, my life has already been preached when I'm laying there in that place. And you think about it tonight, as we look at it here, you know, we had a choice. I'm thinking about the two choices I see here. I see a choice in this chapter. You know, that man that was healed, Bobby, he had a choice he had to make. He had to decide whether right there, you know, he had made his wherewithal all of his life. You've heard me say this. He had made his money at the gate. Hey, they brought it to him. People had, you know, supplied the need that he had. And, you know, and I think we've come to this place in America, you know, too. Let me say this. Hey, if you're getting help in any way, hey, praise the Lord, you need help. I know that there are people out there that are suffering. Hey, people that have disabilities, people that need the help that they're getting. But tonight, I want to tell you something. That, hey, just because you're disabled, hey, that don't mean you can't do anything. You know how I know that? Because I see men in here that are disabled, yet God still uses them in such a mighty way to do that. And do that which is what's needed in the church today, to do that what's needed out there in their lives and their families. Hey, you know, to go out and do that work that God has called them to do.